feeling small when tears are in your eyes. I will dry them all. I'm on your side. Oh, when times get
before we start with the formal proceedings, something to say. That is that we almost didn't have an officiator this morning. Without you knowing, I had the dates mixed up. I thought it was next weekend, and on Thursday, Des at 10 at night, he said to me, listen here, what time are you leaving tomorrow? Have you spoken to the missus? Have you arranged this? I said, for what? For what?
Can you see, Rob?
And then I spoke to him and I realized, hey man, it's this weekend. And we made it. But anyways, guys, I think you would agree with me that these two just met an amazing couple. Are they not beautiful? Even with the tears. Awesome. You'll still realize if you haven't yet even that you can show your emotions. A girl appreciates it so much. Because it means there's something inside her. And that's brilliant. We are to celebrate love today. It's a joyous occasion. In a most stunning location. Two amazing people. And little me. The other day as I went through my papers and things, I realized that coming Friday, 22nd of January.
No, not
September. Thank you. Not good with dates. 22nd of September 2001, I married these two people. And coincidentally, Niki was the bridesmaid. Remember the three C's. Because in a marriage relationship, you need the three C's. First, communication. No matter what kind of communication, because there's going to be good communication, which hopefully will happen most of the time. And there's communication that's not always that late. The silent treatment or the raising of the voice, perhaps, because we have differences of opinion about certain things. But communication is so important, even about the small irritations. Because if you don't talk about the small irritations, that's where the cracks start. You know, you have certain ideas, and you have certain ideas about things, but you don't talk it over. If you don't talk it over, then, as I say, that's when the cracks start. Then the other one is compromise. Everybody also always speaks about compromise. But what is compromise? It depends on the person themselves, because we all have our limits, eh? But sometimes you have to extend your compromise. Because some things are just not that important. I mean, whether you press the tube in the front, in the back, in the middle, what does it matter at the end of the day? So compromise about things that's not that important. But you can't ever compromise on principles. Because principles are there. Once you have to compromise on principles, then everything goes out of the window. Because where's that going to stop? It won't. And then the other C is commitment. Commitment to each other. Commitment to little Neve to bring her up in a lovely, respectful home. And also commitment to your relationship as a family. Because if you're committed to each other, you're committed to the family concept. And you've got it all. then from that, honesty, devotion, and patience, loyalty to each other will come naturally. That's just the way it is. So, I'm going to leave you with three C's. Remember that throughout, because then you'll have a successful marriage and life together. Now, we're going to move over to the vows.
Technology,
yes. Sorry. Here. Right, Niki, we're going to start with you.
Okay.
All right. Deep breath, you're right.
Yeah.
Okay. I believe in you.
I believe in you.
The person you will grow to be.
The person you'll grow to be.
And the couple we will be together.
And the couple we will be together.
With my whole heart.
With my whole heart.
Sorry. I take you as my husband.
I take you as my husband.
Acknowledging and accepting your faults.
Acknowledging and accepting your faults.
And strengths as you do mine.
And strengths as you do mine.
I promise to be faithful and supportive.
I promise to be faithful and supportive.
And to always make our family's love and happiness my priority.
And to always make our family's love and happiness my priority.
I will be yours in plenty and in want.
I will be yours in plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In failure and in triumph.
In failure and in triumph.
I will dream with you.
I will dream with you.
Celebrate with you.
Celebrate with you.
And walk beside you.
And walk beside you.
Through whatever our lives may bring.
Through whatever our lives may bring.
You are my person.
You are my person.
My love and my life.
My love and my life.
Today and always.
Today and always. You have to do it yourself.
I've never been so ready.
I promise to be your lover.
I promise to be your lover.
Companion and friend.
Companion and friend.
Your partner in parenthood.
Your partner in parenthood.
Your ally in conflict.
Your ally in conflict.
Sorry. Your greatest fan.
Your greatest fan.
And your toughest adversary.
And your toughest adversary.
Your comrade in adventure.
Your comrade in adventure.
Your student and your teacher.
Your student and your teacher.
Your consolation in disappointment.
Your consolation in disappointment.
Your accomplice in mischief.
And your accomplice in mischief.
This is my sacred vow to you.
This is my sacred vow to you.
My equal in all things.
My equal in all things.
All things.
All things.
Sorry, I'm good. Cough. You know, I called old Stephen aside now a couple of moments ago, and he said to me, he's never felt so much love in him like as in this moment. That's a compliment to you, but it just shows that you will be a happy family.
Oh, forever.
Right, then to do the legalities, Stephen, do you then declare that as far as you know, there are no legal impediments to your proposed marriage with Niki here present?
I do.
And you call everybody here present as witnesses that you take her to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
In richness and in poverty?
Yeah, I do.
Love? I do. And sickness and health.
I do.
Forever. Until death do you part.
I do.
Niki, you also then call everybody here present as witnesses that you take Stephen here to be your lawful wedded husband.
Do
you also declare that there are no legal impediments to your proposed marriage with Stephen?
I do.
And you take him to be your lawful wedded husband, to love and cherish him through sickness and health, for rich and poor, until death do you part.
I do.
Do you have rings?
Yes.
You can exchange rings. Yeah, just hold it in your hands for the moment.
You're
not. You're not even shivering. Now just there. That's that. If you look at these rings, you will see that there's no beginning and there's no end. And that's a token and a sign of your love for each other. No beginning, no end. You can exchange the rings and then hold each other's right hands. You can put it on. Put it on.
No.
Hold each other's right hands, because that's the contract that seals today's proceedings, that seals your love from now on until death do you part. So hereby then I declare you to be Mr. and Mrs. There you have it. Move to the table just to sign the
register. Typical man standing behind you just in case you fall. Because I know the struggle.
Yeah.
Serious matter that still needs to be finished before we can actually give this wedding our final blessing. We've got to sort out the Lobola. Everyone who doesn't know, Lobola is an African tradition. It's a negotiation between both families, and the bride wanting to marry the groom has to pay a certain amount of cows as part of the whole wedding package. So technology has progressed and we actually have a Lobola app right now. So this is normally quite a lengthy process. It could take a matter of weeks, sometimes even go up to a month, where both families are put in a room and negotiate this payment of these cows for the bride. So to speed things up a little bit, I'm going to ask Glenn, the uncle, because it's tradition that the uncles are involved, to complete Stephen's part of it quickly on the application. It will take 2 seconds for you to run through it. You can maybe help him then. I'll read the question. Yeah. Ask, does Stephen have a job? Yes or no?
Yeah.
What is his net worth capital at this point in time?
Okay, does he own property?
No.
Okay, does he own a car?
No.
You're not doing him any favors here. Does he have a professional job?
No.
Does he have a skilled job?
No.
Does he own a business?
No.
Does he stay with his parents?
Sounds just right, bum.
He doesn't stay with his parents?
No, no, no.
Okay. Is he still a student?
No.
All right. That's you done.
That's me done.
Okay. I think I did you proud.
Now we go to the bride. Okay, so I handpicked this application because there were some embarrassing questions on some of the other applications. So we're going to go down to Trevor. And he needs to answer the bride's portion of it.
What is your age in years?
Okay, so just click on the number.
29.
29. There you go. Okay, scroll up.
That one.
No, no.
Oh, sorry.
This one. Go.
So, having some technical difficulties.
Wrong button. Okay.
You smoke?
Yes. Oh, okay. How many answers do you want to get here?
Education, no matric, matric, tertiary.
Matric.
Okay,
yes. Tertiary. Yeah.
Okay, tertiary. How many kids do you have that you know of?
Just one.
One. Okay. Can you bake?
Mm-hmm. Stephen, you're in trouble.
Yeah.
Are you employed?
Yes. Yes. Good job. Employed higher and higher.
How many sexual partners have you had in the last 12 months?
Was that on the questions?
No, that's not more. Okay, this is select one of the following. Can you clean? And these are the answers.
Yes, when I have enough time. Almost never. Sometimes. Must do it for me, and yes, every day.
When I have time.
Okay.
Do you cook?
Yes.
Every time? Almost every time. Sometimes, almost never. Never.
Almost every time.
Do you think you are lazy?
Yes.
Probably not. Probably not. It's a possibility. Definitely not. Yes, definitely.
Probably not.
Do you drink alcohol? Yes.
Okay. Alright, so now that we've probably taken 2 weeks out of the process with the application. So we go next. Okay, so Steve, I don't know if you want to click submit results.
Oh boy.
Tell us what the story is.
Oh my goodness.
Just click on the submit results there. Find the
your lobola is 35,000, approximately $3,500. It's equivalent to 6 cows.
Okay, so that's the transaction. Until you've paid 6 cows,
you can't leave.
Ian's going to keep the register.
Well, 6 steaks, dude.
Just before we get into everything else here, I just want to say it was quite touching to see Steve up on the stage having a little bit of an emotional breakdown. I think we gave him the wrong shirt. It should have been Brian in the back. We should have made the groom shirt. Just a quick thanks to Donna for all the effort in putting those together. They were fantastic. The only mistake was obviously mixing their 2 shirts up. Yeah, we're going to have quite a fun day. It's going to be different to most weddings, so I think everyone might want something to eat about now. Get a couple of drinks, beers, whatever the story is, and then as soon as we finish that, we'll start the speeches. All right, so we can start with this table.
My dog's gonna get me pissed.
I swear on camera.
No, 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 no
The woman you've become senior with your baby Neve, it warms our hearts. So proud of you. Steve, welcome to the family, but I don't think I need to do that because it was a matter of days, your first trip you came here. Everyone fell in love with you. You've courted my sister, you've courted the family, it was the shortest courtship ever for the family. You've been welcomed long, long time ago, so I don't need to go through that again.
Thank you.
Steve and I are incredibly, we're having a good laugh about it the other day, we're both very competitive. I laugh longer and harder. But we love him, he's a brother to me already, and just, you know, in a very short space of time we've known each other, and got very happy to join our family. Before we start the speeches, I need to ask Des to come up here, please.
This is kind of a letter.
Everyone who's been around the 30 seconds table with Des will know what he's like with this thing. So for the speeches, Des are going to take control of this. We're going to be generous. We're going to give 60 seconds today, but we can just keep an eye on the speeches. That's not going to
be a real pleasure. And the signal for finished speech is time!
Absolute nightmare to play games with. You can get 20 seconds out of that 30 second time every single time. Right, so without further ado, I'm going to ask my mom to come up and start proceedings, and then we'll ask the next people up what she's going to do.
Put that one away.
Okay, remember that intimacy is more than just about the physical. It's about pursuing a life together as a strong couple. Pay attention to the little things, a special thank you, an arbitrary love note, or fulfilling a quirky need. You don't need it. Perhaps set up a regular day camp or plan exciting vacations together. Hopefully many of them include Africa. Always seek to do good for the other person. Most of all, stay intimately in touch with one another's growth over the years, and remember that your partner is your best friend. May you be blessed with a bond of intimacy that stands the test of time.
A joker? Not as bad as Stephen earlier, though, but might be close. When we found out Niki had a new boyfriend, obviously on the other side of the world, and we've got no visibility who Steve is and where he comes from, what he does. And Facebook's normally your first port of call, and you do a little bit of Facebook stalking. And I must say, it was quite an eye-opener. Drunk guys, Peter with Steve with his pants down around his knees. I was horrified, tattoos and all the rest of it, but it actually turned out to be alright. It's not as bad as what we thought it was. Alright, we'll ask Lynn to come up and say a few words.
Kind and generous, and he has a heart of gold. He's
fully and the other one way too close to humour. That should keep you both going. he's honest and he's honourable, and I know that he will keep his family safe and secure. As Stephen's mum, I'm tempted to take all of the credit for the wonderful man he has become. Whilst I did my best to be a good parent and raise him with good morals and values in a secure, loving home, at the end of the day, I'm not really responsible at all for the bad person he is today. Stephen is. He's the person responsible for who he is now. He's a person of exceptional character. He's a beautiful individual inside and out. And I'm so proud to be his mum. I could not ask for him to be any better than he is already. I don't just say this because he is my son. He is someone who I know makes the world a better and happier place. Stephen, I've been proud of you every day of your life, and I'm especially proud of you today. Stephen and Niki, I wish you both nothing but health, happiness, success and endless love. Always be best friends. I love you both very much and always take care of each other. So could you all please raise your glasses?
Yeah, we can. Sorry.
To the new Mr. and Mrs. Weston.
Sorry, did you ever miss that catch? Okay, it's now time for the best man speech. This should be interesting. My mum and Phil took everyone through to Womble's on Tuesday night last week, and the waiter came to read the specials, and it's the same specials week in and week out, but it's a list about this long. And as he finished, Tom stood up and said, "Give that man a hand." he rattled through this long list of specials. I'd like to welcome Tom.
My mom's speech is choking up a little bit there. Before I start my written speech, I'd just like to start with something at the start of my holiday happened, and it really showed me the true meanings of what family's all about. Whether that's your close family, whether that's your extended family, whatever that family is, it brings people together. So I cannot thank Debbie, Phil, Andrea, Derek, Niki, everyone, for being there through the difficult times that we experienced. So I just want to say, raise your glasses for them people, please.
Cheers. Cheers.
To May's health. Right, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Please join me, first of all, a round of applause for the new Mr. and Mrs. Weston. For those of you that don't know, my name's Tom, and I'm the best man of today's group. When I was asked by my brother to be his best man, I was happy in every sense of the word that my brother would want me by his side as his best man on the happiest day of his life. After accepting his offer, started to dawn on me of the responsibilities a best man has, such as organising the stag do. My brother actually did himself. The reason he did it himself is because he knows if he left it to me, we would have just ended up in a dive in our local area, drinking Guinness, just me and him. So, I thank you for that. Writing the best man speech, selecting outfits for the big day, what really stuck in my mind is what a best man actually is. It should be someone that's always there in the most difficult times. Someone that's always got your back. Someone that never fails to put a smile on your face when you're down. But most of all, someone that is always true to who they are. And considering all those things, today, young man, you're my best man.
You always have been.
From the day I started school, my brother and I began to share many memories, such as banging our heads together purposely to get the day off school. To my brother fighting my corner when I was mugged in the streets. Or even down to the time my brother came home from work with a face like a slapped ass because he'd been sacked from work. And when I asked him, he replied, when I asked him why he got sacked, he replied, because the man sent his food back twice, and on the third time, I poured his drink over his head. I don't see why he got sacked. Then as we got a bit older and a bit wiser, memories became a bit more blurred, mainly thanks to this stuff sat in front of you all today. But still, these are memories that I'll treasure forever. Forever and ever. My best man, he got me my first job after leaving school. And during my first job, my brother taught me many things, such as how to slack off. And to always look busy at the same time. How to make a terrible cup of tea and coffee so no one would ever ask you again. But he also taught me how to graft to where I wanted to get to in life. He taught me how to make friends. He taught me how to be confident and also how to inflict my confidence onto other people. Wherever my brother goes, people seem to love him. People want him around. People always remember the time they met Stephen Weston. Because he truly is one in a million. Then came a time in my life when I no longer had my brother directly by my side. Because he decided to move 150 miles away after he punched a work colleague square in the face and decided he wanted to change the scenery. But of course, 2 years down the line, as always, I followed my brother's footsteps. And again, we were side by side in a small place called Grey Yarmouth. The place where many people go to end their life. But not mine, Stevens. This is where ours began. Once again, we were inseparable. We began to play rugby together again, and from this, more unforgettable memories were made. Such as the house we lived in, one castle we're in. But unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, there's only one rule once we left One Castle Green, and that was to never talk about One Castle Green. Mainly because we'd end up locked up. The one thing I can tell you about One Castle Green, to try and paint a small picture of what the place was like, is the house next door sold for a record 6 times in 2 years. Sadly, we had to move from One Castle Green, but not so sadly, we ended up with the lives we are living today. And the memories we have will live on forever. Memories do help us build the people we become today. And today, brother, I'm proud of the person you've become. But we cannot place all the praise on the people we have become from our memories alone. The main reason Niki is so lucky to have such a loving, caring, respectful husband today is all down to the lady sitting right there.
Wow. Here he goes again. Just give me a minute on this one, guys.
You've got to start that timer for me over there. Growing up without a father to most people would sound awful. But not when the mother you were dealt with makes up for 10 fathers. She is the sole reason that me and my brother are who we are today. Without you, Mum, we wouldn't know right from wrong. We wouldn't know how to respect women. We wouldn't know what it's like to be a family. We wouldn't know how to express our love for one another and our ladies. We wouldn't know how to be fantastic parents to the 2 beautiful children we've brought into this world. And of course, Mum, we won't be so goddamn handsome. You all should be so proud of the man sitting over there, because I know that I am. Deep down. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you all to join me in wishing the new Mr. and Mrs. Weston a happy future together and many happy memories to the bride and groom.
I think Tom needs a huge round of applause before you start. His hands were shaking. Yeah. Alright, so I think maybe we should have a 10-minute break before we bring on the man of the hour. Everyone needs to go to the toilet, recharge their glasses or anything like that, and then we'll bring Steve on to close us off with the speeches.
Life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started to hum. Still, it's a real good bet. The best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Oh, wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day you're mine.
The groom comes up and says a few words. So based on what's happened so far today, I think the water works out.
Yeah.
Just before he comes up, we took Steve and Tom out with a close friend of mine on Thursday evening. And I just want to reiterate something that he said to you guys. I don't know if you'll remember that late into the evening. They were a little bit past their expiry date. But there's a whole somewhere on a farm, somewhere in South Africa with your name on it. You heard my sister. You've seen all the toys and all the rest of the universe. No, I'm serious. Welcome Steve up, please.
Because I'm just going to speak from the heart, you know.
Well, look, Steve, what's that one? Hold on, Steve, I'm going to see where you're going. But I'll tell you where you can go.
Go.
Okay, you can go now.
Right, okay. Well, I think...
I can't hear you yet.
I can't hear you yet. Open your ears on that. Right, I'd like to start by thanking my beautiful wife. She's the best mum to our baby, and she makes me a better person personally. You know, she pushes me forward, you know, and she makes me feel loved every single day since we've been together. And she's just perfect in every way. And thank you. And I promise to look after you for the rest of my life, and keep you and my baby absolutely safe. So thank you so much. I'd like then to move on to Debbie and Phil, because I remember 3 years ago when I first came here, and it was all new, and I walked out there and I said, one day I'd like an arch there, I'd like the seats like this, I'd like the tables like this. And she's gone absolutely above and beyond, and everything that I said 3 years ago, never been mentioned since, you've done, and you've just made our day absolutely perfect. And I hope the stress was worth it. So thank you so much, Debbie and Phil. Thank you so much. I'd then like to move on to the beautiful flower girls. Absolutely stunning. I love you absolutely to the end of the world. Back. Where's May?
Asleep.
Oh, she's gone to sleep. All right, I'll say thank you to May when she wakes up. They couldn't have looked any more stunning. And I'm so proud of every single one of them. So thank you very much.
Time. That's it.
You can't keep
him alive.
Is that 60 seconds?
No, but I had a few.
Felt
sips.
A lot longer.
Yeah, I had a few sips of things. I don't think we'll be talking about.
I'd like to move on to Jenny, Des, Donna,
Like Des, Yummy and Bits, that was the best surprise I could have ever wished for.
You heard us all in.
You know. Absolutely amazing. Thank you so much. Thank you for the t-shirts, Donna. They were absolutely lovely. And Jenny, thank you so much as well for all your hard work. And I just love you all as a family, and Gary as well. And your beautiful baby boy, he's absolutely stunning. Right, this is not going as well as the others, but... Garrick, thank you for being master of ceremonies. Just remember, I'll do the jokes, you do the funny faces, you got head start. So, thank you very much. And you are like a brother to me too. Since the first day, like you said, it was a couple of days, and we was chucking beer down and we were shooting, and every time I come to South Africa, he takes me out, he shows me a great time, you know, and I love you to bits.
Only off so to thank you very much. Project, eh?
Right. Ian, thank you so much for the beautiful ceremony today. It was absolutely stunning. Thank you. The only criticism I could make is you're crap at darts. Absolutely. The next time I'm not going to be on your team. So, and then to my family who have travelled so far, I really, really appreciate it. And you can't pick your family. But if I could have done, I'd have picked you guys. I love you all to pieces. And then on to Stuart, Jess, and the Basils. From the word off, you brought me into your family, made me feel so welcome. And when we did live there, when we come over, my highlight is to spend the day at Gran and Grandad's house. And I know Gran finds it a compliment when I fall asleep on the settee, because I feel so comfortable there. So thank you so much. Shanti, to the caterers, and Johan and your team, you all work incredibly hard and so informative on the game drives, and you always show us a good time when we're here. Shanti, thank you very much for the photos. The engagement ones were absolutely brilliant, and the little box together was amazing. I loved it. On to my best man. He's not only my brother, he is actually my best mate, and probably my only mate. You know, and through thick and thin, we've been together, and we always will be, you know. I'm going to struggle to follow your speech, because that was absolutely amazing. So thank you so much. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, brother.
So, where are we?
Ah, well.
Time!
And my mum.
And my mum. She's just called time.
My mum's not only been my mum, as you heard from Tom, she's also been my dad as well. And like I say, I couldn't have wished for a better dad. She's stood on the rugby line and watched me in the snow, the rain. You know, she's always there for when we need her. And she's never let me down yet in the 30 years I've been around. And I know you will, Mum. And you look stunning today as well. I love you so much. And I just want to end on everyone as a family. I've always dreamed of having a big family and doing things together like we do. And I think with marrying Niki, other than Niki being my bride, my dreams have all come true today. And I just want to say to each and every one of you that I absolutely love you madly. I got that from Jess. But I absolutely love you to pieces, and I couldn't be more happy. I feel blessed. You know, I'm not very good at speeches, but I'm trying to get it all across. And I should have wrote something down, really. I'm trying to speak from the heart. I hope that every single person here, I'd just like to raise a toast to you guys, because it's just been an amazing time. And my son may continue. I love you all so much. Thank you. I ain't missed no one off, have I? Grant, you're my favourite. Yeah. I didn't want to miss you out. Thank you, guys.
going. So Niki's just asked me to quickly say a few words as well on behalf of her, to my mom, and all this effort and everything like that. This is both of their dream weddings. I said they couldn't have done anything better than what's happened thus far, and we're only a small portion into the wedding. So I'd like to say thank you to you for everything.
Thank you so much for all the energy.
Thanks to Cole for opening up your place here and all the memories and everything that you made here. It's absolutely spectacular. My sister, again, I'm so proud of you. You've done such a good job with Neve. Your choice in men, we can live with it. You know? He's great fun. Everyone's fallen in love with him. Our kids as well. Makes me a little bit worried about the men that they choose. That's okay, everyone's in love with it. So these things don't come together as easy as what it seems. If you have a look at everything that's taken place, I mean, just leaving my mom's house. Niki was driving the Viana.
Not my fault, by the way.
The Viana went left, the trailer went straight into the neighbor's yard. It wasn't hooked up properly. I panicked because I got a panic call from my mom. I rushed over there and I forgot my wedding outfit back in Joburg. I only realized halfway here. So we had to stop in Nelspruit and try to find a new outfit. No offense to you guys, but I would have been dressed like Johan and Orky and everyone else here. You know, that's all you can find in Nelspruit. So I don't want to be confused of being a ranger, but no offense to you guys. But again, to my mom and everyone else involved in putting this all together, all the extended family and Donna and Des and Trevor and Alison, everyone who came from all over the country, or the world, should I say, it really is appreciated. I think we're done with all the formalities. We've got a game drive at 2 o'clock. We're going to take photographs by Big Dan.
Yeah, can everybody please go on the game drive because we've got photographs. In case anybody can
down. Yeah. And then after the game drive, we're going to come back here and there's going to be a dinner served. So thank you everyone for your time.
Well, if you're interested in
fall in love, it will be forever, or I'll never fall in love in a restless world like this is. Love is ended before it's begun, and too many moonlight kisses seem to cool in the warmth of the sun.
When I give my heart, it will be I can feel the
You're a falling star. You're the getaway car. You're the line in the sand when I go too far. You're the swimming pool on an August day. And you're the perfect thing to say. And you play it coy, but it's kinda cute. Oh, when you're smiling at me, you know exactly what you do. Baby, don't pretend that you don't know it's true. 'Cause you can see it when I look at you. And in this crazy life, and through these crazy times, it's you, it's you. You make me sing your every line, your every word, your everything. You're a carousel, you're a wishing well, and you light me up when you ring my bell. You're a mystery, you're from outer space, you're every minute of my everyday. And I can't believe that I'm your man, and I get to kiss your baby just because I can. Whatever comes our way, I will see it through. And you know that's what all love can do. And in this crazy life, and through these crazy times, it's you, you make me sing your every line, your every word, your everything.